Hey guys, Brittany here. I'm back with another quick workout for you. Today we're gonna be using a loop band to work our glutes and our hamstrings. So this is an awesome workout that you can do on the go. Just grab your loop band and take it with you wherever you're going. So we are gonna go ahead and start in a seated position. You're gonna take the band and you're just gonna place it over your feet and walk it so it's up over your thighs. And if you don't have a loop band but you have a resistance band, you can always just tie the band into a loop. Then we're gonna go ahead and come onto our hands and our knees into a quadruped position. Your hands are gonna be right underneath your shoulders, your knees are gonna be right underneath your hips. Make sure that band is above your knees and not on it. And we're gonna start by extending one leg straight back behind you. Toe is pointed, knee is pointed down to the floor, and you're gonna lift it up, keeping that knee pointed right down to the floor. And we're just gonna tap it up an inch and down an inch. Up an inch and down an inch. Now for some people, this quadruped position is really uncomfortable. If it is, you can always come down onto your forearms. Just make sure you're not arching through your back as your range of motion for your leg will be a little bit greater. Good, otherwise, you could always make your hands into fists and come up onto your knuckles, creating a little extension through your wrists instead of flexion. Or you could grab some weights and hold on to those like this, basically, keeping the same position. Two more. Last one. Now let's pulse it out. Little pulses up and up. Now you want to avoid dumping into your supporting hip. You want to keep the weight even in between both sides and maybe a little bit more towards your working side so that you're not dumping into that supporting leg. And you wanna corset those abs up and in. You can even grab onto them and feel to make sure they're pulling up and in. Four more like this. Three, two, and one. Now take that leg, you're gonna tap it down, squeeze, lift up. Down, squeeze, lift up. Check your leg and make sure that knee is still pointing down to the mat as you're doing this. Tap and lift. Tap and lift. Good. Three more like this. Two, we're gonna add on. Last one, here we go. We're gonna lower, lift. Now cross behind to the opposite shoulder, tap down, lift up. We lower, lift, cross, tap behind, lift up. Again, lower, lift, cross, lift up. Tap down and up, cross behind and lift. So as you cross behind, you want to make sure you're keeping your hips stable and not allowing them to shift from side to side. So even if you have to take a smaller range of motion. Last one here, hold it center, little pulses up and up. Good. Four more, three, two, now flex the foot. Toes point right down to the mat, keep pulsing here. Breathe. Four, three, two, now bend your leg and stamp that heel up on the ceiling. Really feel that hamstring engage here, your glute squeezing as you pulse up and up. Keep it going, you have eight more. Seven, six, five, give me four, three, two, point your toe, turn your knee out to the side and keep pulsing the legs. You're gonna feel that side glute turn on here. Good, pulse up and up. Keep it going for four, three, two, let's bend and extend that leg. It goes out and in. So now the knee is still turned out to the side as you do this. Feel those glutes working. Four more. Three, two, last one. Hold it there. Extend the leg as much as you can, like I have a string on your toe and I'm pulling it from behind you. And bring it down. Nice job. Sit it back, take one little rest, and then come straight back up into your position. Let's extend the opposite leg. Toe extends behind you, knee points down. Lift it up to hip height, and we go up an inch and down an inch. Up an inch and down an inch. Simply going to the other side here, working hard, squeezing into your glute as you do this. Up and down. Lift up and down. Keep it going. Now I want you to make sure as you're here, you're looking out to the top of your mat. So you're not looking directly down and allowing your chin to drop, but right to that edge of your mat here. Four more like this. Three, two, straighten that knee. Last one, little pulses up and up and up. Keep corseting those abs up and in, pull them in. Feel how hard they're working here, even as we work our glutes. Eight more, breathe. Keep the move small, four, three, two, let's tap the mat. We tap down, squeeze, lift. Tap down, squeeze, lift. You got this. Keep it going. Just four more here, then we add on. Don't dump into that supporting hip, check it. And last one, now we go lower, lift, cross behind and up. And if you have something in your way, you could always shift forward, cross behind and up. Tap down, lift, cross behind and up. Again, lower, lift, cross and lift. So I'm really feeling this leg, especially if because it's already been my supporting leg. I've been holding up my body weight as I worked my first side. So this leg, you might feel it fatigue faster. Down and up, hold it here. Pulse it up and up and up. Keep going, four, three, two. Now flex your foot, keep pulsing here and pulse, pulse. Four, three, two. Now bend the leg, pulse that foot up to the sky. Stamp that foot on the ceiling here. Pulse up and up, squeezing through your glutes. You have eight. Breathe. Give me four, three, two. Point that toe, turn the knee out to the side, getting that attitude position so you're feeling that side glute turn on. That's it. Keep that spine nice and neutral, no arching. Four, three, two. Let's bend and extend. It goes out, bend in, out, bend in. Keep going, out and in. You got it. Come on, just four more here. Three, two, hold it out there, elongate the leg, and come all the way down. Nice job, sit it back, roll out those wrists. Take a moment to stretch it out, and you did an awesome job. I will see you again real soon.